a real fan. I don't know how many interviews you had is like real fans and not like. Yeah, but I'm talking about like.
I hope everybody's a real fan.
I'm talking about 10 years.
I hope everybody like that.
I'm talking about White Horse High.
Damn, that's deep.
Lay in.
That's hard.
I'll tell
Snow
you.
Snow Nose.
Yeah, that's hard.
I'll tell you the Rashad.
My little brother listened to you. Generational
that
type
music,
shit.
That's music that wasn't even supposed to be nowhere for nothing.
I don't even know how we got there.
Yeah.
I know Rashad maybe, what, 7 years?
Yeah.
And we started 997 6 years ago. And he had put me onto your shit early, but introed your shit to me as like, this is my favorite rapper in high school.
Ain't gonna lie. Real shit, that's too. I graduated.
I hear that title a lot though,
bro. 2012.
I hear younger than that. I hear niggas say since elementary school.
That's crazy. My brother was in middle school, so we living in the same house. But obviously, I put him on. So that's that's his era, probably like sixth grade.
I'm happy to be here, man. Happy to be here for so long.
You a real generational nigga, bro.
Thanks.
You really made it.
Y'all making me feel. I ain't even old.
Yeah, that's what's crazy. That's what's crazy. You really not old. So
31. I'm 31. I mean, feel like I'm 50.
Nah, facts.
Legacy shit though.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna get into it. We gonna get into early shit, bro. I want to see if you can talk. I want some Narwhal shit here. Let me see if you can get into early Stone Mountain, early Atlanta. We talking Jacob Lattimore. We talking.
The boy,
yeah.
The
so can
actor.
Yeah. Can we talk about that era of your life, early key?
What you know?
Come on, man.
I had a.
I know some things. I'm gonna let you lead it, and
I'm
then I'll see.
I feel like I don't know if it was you outside or something like that.
I was outside a little bit.
I had a
bit.
Moment. It was me, Tisa, and he was doing like some freestyling shit in Little 5 Points.
Okay.
Tisa, with the nigga. You feel me? Like, and he was just randomly in Little 5 Points, and he was having kids freestyle for him.
Okay.
And I think Jacob Lattimore was like a singing, dancing nigga at the time.
Yeah.
And Jacquees was there, too. He was one. Jacquees and Jacob Lattimore was best friends right there.
That's crazy. Mm-hmm. Larry June.
Yep, Larry.
At this time.
That one, just not the same time.
It's a different time.
I don't maybe not have known Larry.
Okay.
I didn't know him then.
Okay. Okay.
I met Larry later on in my life.
Bet. All right. So then we're going to move on a little bit.
If that's what you're talking about? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. Yeah.
You was there?
I wasn't there. But I did research.
Okay.
I know some things.
All right, cool.
But, all right, boom. From there, we're going
to.
What
Shout
are
out to Little 5 Points, man. Atlanta, Georgia, man. Y'all know it's an artsy district. It's historical, but I feel like it was kind of white until we kind of. Did what we did to it, and not so much of a Afrocentric way, but in a cooler way.
Yes.
Was that the beginning of you starting to like freestyle and be doing shit with other people?
I wasn't even really rapping then. I was probably making beats only. Mm. And it's just an opportunity, like just fucking Tisa. Like, I don't want to be in the hood, nigga. I'm gonna do whatever.
Yeah. bet.
And he was cool. Like, I'm like, I only knew him for fashion at that point. I didn't know that he did music and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy that Tisa was even tapped in. That you even was
just
tapped in.
Around,
yeah, that's
though.
Crazy.
He was just outside. It wasn't even like.
For those who don't know, that's the T.I.
Yeah,
$A, the flip to the whole Tisa, retro.
That like everybody's
Taz
press
Arnold.
Photo. There everybody's press photo during the blog era had something of that.
Shout out to Taz Arnold, man. Real OG.
The Big Sean.
He don't know me, though. Yeah. He's not going to remember me.
You remember him, bro.
Yeah,
you
I
was there.
Remember him for sure.
I bet there. He knows you.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah.
All right, so we got. I'm gonna do three titles. See what's going on. Golden Glide, Cascade, Sparkles. What do the names mean to you?
Everything.
Yeah. Why?
Because they're skate rinks.
Skate rinks. What does the skating really inform your music, or how does it inform your music?
If you're from Atlanta, you know that them teachers is lazy, and that's the only fucking field trip that you get is to go to the skate rink. In the summer camp, you go there every day. And I'm like, what the fucking point of y'all having a facility if we just put us in the skate rink?
Yeah.
But we grew up in all them skate rinks. I grew up in every single skate rink in the city.
Okay. So you would say that's kind of like influenced how you make music or the music that you like?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to do a little deep dive. SoundCloud deep dive real quick. All
right, bet.
Song that you
this
probably
is easy.
Forgot.
You
probably
what you
forgot,
was talking
though.
About, you was digging deep.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah, I was going back. I moved up. I just had all to right. give you the Narwhal at the beginning. All right, but all right, so remember this song, Dipped in Butter.
Okay, yep.
Why don't you use more house records, or is that directly coming from the skate world?
My man, Yo Sig just put me like, yeah. My man, Yo Sig, he with me right now, but he kind of put me into that wave, like, yo, you should just rap on this, because I'm more so like, I be trying to sing on shit, like, and he's like, nah, just rap.
Yeah.
And that wasn't that long ago. I kind of think it was like last year, right?
Yeah.
So that's how that about came about, but we done actually copied that blueprint, that formula, and carried on to new music that hasn't released yet.
Yeah, that's honestly, that shit is coming out now. Like, a lot of other people.
I ain't gonna hold you. I heard somebody playing it the other day. Cause yeah. I forget that song is even out, because it's like, it was really us just practicing. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't nobody for, you know. I feel like that's what SoundCloud is. Like, it's like, it's like, yo, this is my practice work.
Yeah.
And you can see who I'm gonna become sometimes, but sometimes it's just, you already there.
Yeah, we started this shit off of SoundCloud for real. Like, like, that's how you discover artists at the time. Like, that's how I really found you. That's how I found a lot of artists. And honestly, shout out to SoundCloud.
Shout out to SoundCloud. Existing.
SoundCloud as like a discovery tool still is goated in my opinion.
Yeah, no, still like, every day. Like, I just did a deal with them. But before, if I wasn't doing a deal with them, I'd still be using them hands on. Like,
facts.
You know what I'm saying? I was giving them my money and everything. Yeah,
yeah.
Paying for you making money with them, so it's like, there's a lot of other companies starting to do shit like that. But it gets too confusing.
I still think, like, even just on a, like, interface level of, like, the way you can go from one song to the other, see what is liked there, see what's related.
Right. And
like,
then it's really artists dealing with each other. Like, yeah. Like I haven't checked my messages. I probably got, like, a million messages on fucking SoundCloud. But, like, they got a section out to where somebody, another verified artist talks to you. So I've met artists through there.
Facts.
Like, you know.
A lot.
I appreciate SoundCloud.
To kind of jump off of the SoundCloud wave, I say, this might be the first you put on a lot of artists.
I'm from every sounds click. Sound yeah, close. You feel me? All
so
of that shit.
I say these are some artists I first heard from your SoundCloud that you could kind of verify, not verify. I feel like a lot of people you might have put on first, but Post Malone, Cardi, Uzi,
these
Yachty, Conan,
21
for sure,
Kenny Beats. And I stopped there. But those that list is like, I don't know if they all was first
SoundCloud.
On your SoundCloud, but it was pretty close.
Yeah, yeah. Macko, did you say him?
Oh, yeah, I didn't say OG.
I dropped Macko shit.
Yeah, okay.
We dropped the whole project, but I dropped it, bitch, you guessed it.
Yeah.
Them bitches, I ain't gonna hold all them songs, it ain't no lie, because my numbers look crazy on SoundCloud.
Those are all, like, big artists. Now, you're not a big artist, but those are, like...
I am a big artist.
Yeah, you are a huge artist. And those are also global artists. So it's crazy that... You was there so early. This is 6, 7, 8, 9 years ago. Mm-hmm. So what would you say is your A&R process, if you even have any, on top of SoundCloud?
Well, at the moments, I was just generally happy that I'm finding somebody. Like, I came from more of a producer standpoint. So it's like, I'm like, I have this. Mm. And, I mean, because, like, it's kind of different. Because Post... Did anybody know about Post?
Nah. No. Did you? I think you reposted White Iverson when I seen it, and that was pretty much it, bro. Like, I don't even think he had hella songs or nothing.
I feel like I put that shit on Twitter.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, that's what it was first, and then that shit blew up instantly, because I remember, rest in peace, but Mac hit me up instantly. It was like, who is this? Mm. And then everybody was hitting me up. Damn, I did do a lot on SoundCloud.
Alone. Yeah, wrist. So we didn't even. We were talking about that earlier. About this is like a wrist.
McConan. I was chasing McConan's swag though, because McConan was like one of the first ones. Like, I was really chasing his swag.
Yeah. So this is another era of you where we can kind of talk about, I guess, the 2009 era.
Yeah, yeah.
Where that's what you say you was chasing the swag, or just because y'all was in proximity, like a lot of people living together or in the same.
Who McConan?
Just 2009 and McConan. McConan by himself.
McConan had a manager.
Yeah.
Who had his website that was only post McConan's music, which was genius.
Mm.
And I'm like, yo, that shit is hard. And that's how everybody discovered McConan. And then it just trickled onto whatever website was coming out that you had to go fuck with him. But shout out to McConan. They had something going right at that moment, because they was doing weird ass fucking videos.
Yeah.
It'd just be him standing there with like a fucking mannequin head. You feel what I'm saying? It ain't getting hella views, but the right people are looking at it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what's going on in the world. I don't know if kids, if y'all need to know that. It ain't about having a million views. It's about who is,
Who know, looking at it?
Yeah, that should be the one.
I mean, Matt, I think we are a true real. Testament to that, honestly, because
I don't even believe in that millions of shit. Nah. Shit. That shit ain't even real.
Nah, it's who's in your who's in your community, who's in your corner.
Right, right. Who's looking at, who's really a fan? Like, you know, I ain't going to hold you. Drake is a fan of my music, so that's more important than having 500 people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Where he can, you know what I'm saying?
And that's like the McConan shit, too. When, like, when Drake hops on Tuesday, it was like the craziest moment for anybody.
I seen it coming. We saw it coming.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We be with Mike, though. Like, we are in the center, in the forefront of, like, what's going on. So,
yeah, can we talk about Mike Will, my boy, also Miles Harris, who, I mean, I went to high school with Miles and shit like that. So that's my boy.
Are you from North Carolina?
You know, that's Charlotte. How I know Charlotte. Yeah, I know. Yeah, shout out my boy, yeah. Pauly Guwap. Yeah, you know, yeah, shout out Miles and them.
You
so,
really got to shout out Miles. I feel like you never.
I never
really
shout out Miles because he be hustling,
Miles,
doing his thing, bro.
He got real hits.
Yeah,
he been making, Ray Sherman, all of that.
Yeah, yeah, bro. He been making music since we was like 14.
He fire too, like.
Yeah, bro. Money go for Miles.
Money go for Miles. Go look him up, bro. That's the dog.
Super fire. I know. I'm sure he sells packs and.
Yeah.
I'm sure
he outside.
He's fire.
He good. He good. And he put me on to all that spiritual shit. Before that shit was cool, bro. That boy Miles is.
I went to his crib in Charlotte after a show, right?
Yeah.
I don't even know what you're talking about. I know this though.
Yeah. I know.
I went to his crib, and I was at his mama's house or something like that, and they were doing a fucking bonfire in the backyard.
Yeah. I know exactly what you're talking about with his sister and shit. And those are my peoples. Those are my, like, my family.
Oh, that's
family.
Hot.
So I already know. That's how I did my little research and everything.
Yeah, okay, cool.
But, yeah, bro, talk about the Mike Will shit. Obviously, we're going to kind of get into, I don't know how much you can say about your writing and everything, but
I can say anything at this point. I mean, that shit don't mean nothing, bro. If it's me, it's my intellectual property.
Okay, so how do you feel? How was it working with Mike Will and then Benza Make Her Dance? Is, I'll probably say, one of your biggest things.
I ain't gonna really speak on that because I wasn't just me by myself.
All right, bet.
And it wasn't just me.
Nigga said, all right, anything is cool, but nah, not
I
that one.
No, it's not just that, though. That's Juicy J's song, though.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Juicy J brought me that song. Like,
all right, bet.
So however it went, the way it goes, the song was already made. I didn't make the famous Bands That Make Her Dance.
Okay, yeah. Okay. You just contributed.
I contributed a lot.
Bet. Let's leave it at that.
That's a great song, though.
It is. It is a classic. It's a classic.
But I feel like it was hands on. Like, it's other people that's involved that don't get talked about on that song.
Yeah, that's how it goes. So, can you talk about the writing world then? How do you like writing? Do you?
I ain't even really too much tapped into the writing world yet. Everything that I've done up until now is just like on accident or. Mm. Or it's like a homie thing, but this is how this is what they do with me, per se. A nigga had me come in the studio and do references or had me record there, and they'd be like, we don't need nothing. Then I leave, and I hear back, and everything I just did over there, y'all just recorded it.
Yeah, yeah.
You feel me? So it's a lot of time like that, but most of the songs that I think are big that I'm a part of, I'm still on it. I don't think nobody's ever taken me off of it.
Yeah, and this is like... Like Cozy Tapes era, shit like that.
Cause we did Gucci Mane first song when he got out of prison, and I ain't never even met Gucci Mane before, and that motherfucker just went gold.
Damn.
How did that happen?
That first day
that
out. What
Rocky.
Song was that? First day out.
Oh, through Rocky.
Yeah, nah.
Oh,
ASAP Rocky.
Oh, okay.
We did.
Okay.
Shut up. I had already had the song.
Okay.
I had a full version of that song. With my man Franchise, Franchise did it. He's a producer from Texas, and. We had the full song, and then I showed Flacco the song, and he was like, yo, Gucci Mane just got out of jail. He just called me, and then I sent him the song. They sent it back like in an hour.
Damn, that's crazy. Yeah. I don't know if I knew. That was one I didn't know.
And I ain't really got to celebrate that moment yet because that bitch just went gold, but I'm like, I only never met Gucci Mane in my life.
That's fire. All right, so... Let's talk about music coming out now and just like how your process has changed.
Sorry, y'all, excuse my yawning.
Nah, you good, bro. How your process has changed from like White Horse High all the way up until now, or new shit you got coming out? Or if it's the same process.
Nah, it ain't the same process. I ain't gonna hold you. My older music, especially the music that you're talking about, that's before this, well, that is a SoundCloud wave. But I ain't know nobody's paying attention to that.
A lot.
You look at your career and the music that you dropped in those kind of eras from like SoundCloud Wave.
I don't even be looking at that. I look back so far as like the 2014.
Yeah.
When I felt like I was like solidified as some type of artist already all the way up until 2014 that I'm never going to be again. I never performed those songs, nothing. I never performed none of them songs. Yeah, and those are amazing songs, but like that was a whole different person. I used to write. I can't even write to save my fucking life now.
You can't write.
But I used to write. Like I used to be at my grandma's house on the floor with my feet up, nigga. You feel me?
Feet in the air.
Dangling
like
my feet, writing, nigga.
Nah, that's crazy. Yeah, so,
especially my first project. That's all that was.
Yeah. And now
even,
you just.
Even like 2014, I love my grandma. If anybody know me, I stand by my grandma forever. But she, I think like some of the songs we did with 21, me and 21, we did them in my grandma's house.
Okay, that's crazy.
Like my grandma be like in the room, like I'm talking about, like she walking in and out right there. Yeah. And we like,
Victor, I jump in the tunnel over there.
No, like, for real. Nah, that's crazy. I don't think a lot of people even know you. You're not. I don't know if you started it, but you was one of the first 21 Savage. Still Man Savage. That was like a whole...
They started that.
They started that.
That's like a Glenwood thing.
And then you was just helping them.
I mean, that's
just
like some Atlanta type thing. Nah, okay. I mean, Man is my brother.
Okay.
I actually known 21 before I knew Man.
Okay.
I went to middle school with him and high school. Then we was growing up. We grew up and I seen him in the club and then... I'm like, well, I'm rapping at this point. I know it's a lot of going on in my neighborhood. So I'm like, hey, what y'all got going on? He like, I'm like, I rap. You see it. Obviously, I'm with Juicy J at the time. And I'm like, I rap. And he like, and I'm like, yeah, come pull us to the studio. And right then, like, we kind of like, it was probably about a year we was inseparable.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
That's crazy. So shout out to 21 too. He just got a fucking big.
Yeah, man, that nigga's huge.
Yeah, he's a super duper star.
That's crazy. I ain't gonna hold. I don't tell nobody. I'll be proud of my damn self.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, you should. Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't make him or nothing like. But like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I did watch that shit come from nothing to not even. I can't even imagine where he is right now. But the music though is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like, I watched it and I learned so much from him too. But like, still, like, I never even was trying to grow an artist. But my whole career, I've been trying to produce an artist. Like. Like still to this point where I still haven't done it to my full hilarity because they would still be with me, or you know what I'm saying. But like 2009, I started, and like I didn't start the artist. I started a home for artists. You feel what I'm saying? So I always wanted to just be a home. I don't never want to be like I gave this nigga something that they already had.
Yeah. Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's crazy, bro. That's crazy. I feel like you was, even though you haven't personally followed through the whole career, I feel like you was definitely in the hands of a lot of motherfuckers' careers. Yeah. So, yeah, man.
A lot of people helped me too, though. I ain't gonna hold you.
Yeah.
Yeah. We want to speak on some of the people that kind of helped you as you was coming up too, that gave you kind of some of the game you got now.
It's a long list of people. I got some music industry fans too, so but like if you know like Brian Johnston, I don't know where he works at right now, but he might be at Interscope, might be at Atlantic. I don't know where the fuck he works at now, but I know he used to work. He came up with Pharrell, but that's like one of my first mentors ever in music. It only lasted for like 6 months, but I learned so much in that 6 months. Like because you was talking about Shakir, and that was my first time ever coming to LA, going flying, getting on a plane.
Oh damn! And then, first flight shit you gonna remember for the rest of your life.
And it was to a record deal. Like nigga, I was like, you feel me? So that was my education. Fine. So shout out to Brian Johnston. Shout out to Mike Will. He's a real teacher to me. As much as me being my brother, I done been to studios where you cannot go in. I didn't even know it was studios like that. Like Conway, like with Justin Bieber and you know what I'm saying, like. A human feeling extra, like, thanks. Like, you know what I'm saying? For whatever the reason, but yeah.
Yeah.
Who else? Juicy J is my mentor, too. Jimmy Nichols, I don't know. There's a lot of people out there. I don't want to miss nobody. So I don't like doing lists, bro.
Nah, it's cool. Nah, you don't got to go through the whole list.
Yeah, it's
but
a lot of people. But some as fans, some people want to know, especially like teenagers, they want that sauce. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I ain't got no problem getting it to them.
I think it
pause.
I think like what one thing we've a lot of the guests that we've had over the years are like industry insider, like if you know people, even like Key Henderson.
Shout out to her, that's my mentor too.
Big shout out to Key, huge supporter of us, the reason why you're here right now. And that's been like for listeners of our show, it's like
that's why they listen.
We have a guest on, and then they can go follow that person, and then get the get you know, some of those
gems,
little nuggets, yeah, from that person. And it's just like basically like
plant
lining seed up the cookie crumbs, like for them to follow and figure out where to go.
Yeah, and that's going, speaking of what you were saying earlier, where it's just like really who you know, and that's kind of like
right.
how we got here. We ain't have no Joe Budden numbers, you feel me, or none of that, but we got the JV and all the same shit. It's just
the world, it's easy to shine a light on yourself if you defy right now.
Yeah.
If you're talented, it's easy to shine a light on yourself. Like, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people trying to, my fucking mom and my grandma was trying to start podcasts right now.
Yeah. Are they?
Yeah.
That's fire.
Whenever, everybody is, though.
Yeah, everybody
is. It's at Best Buy, nigga.
Yo, let us know. Yeah. We gotta bring your mama and your grandma into the orchard. We got it.
Yeah,
we got
get
it.
The podcast.
Get
deal
that JV.
For,
let's
for
go.
For mama and grandma. Let's go.
What is their podcast going to be about?
I think my mama had some shit she was trying to do. My stepmom, she was trying to do some shit with, like, she was selling, like, products or some shit. Like
yo,
that.
I love
or, like,
that.
Reviewing products and stuff like that.
That's nah, like that. People are like, everyone there and mama have a podcast right now. And you're like, literally.
Everyone and their mama should be the name of the podcast.
Yeah,
that's
everybody
hard.
Everybody and mama, not for sure. Yeah. Uncle pop up. Ooh, this is my time. Sport.
Nah, that's actually a good concept on the low.
She's like giving out like recipe tips.
Yeah,
like,
that's
set,
what they do. That's
yeah.
what they want.
This set should be the living room and the kitchen, you feel me?
Everybody's planning on doing a podcast
yeah.
right now.
Yeah. Nah, I ain't gonna lie. Our boy Jamal, he put me on to the cooking YouTube where it's actually somebody mama and like they son, and she old and shit, but
oh,
she
yeah.
just be in there cooking. They got
a
fire.
YouTube is a university,
shit,
my
though.
Guy.
Like, bro,
YouTube,
so many fire recipes.
YouTube is a whole school.
Oh, God. All right, so let me, you going to introduce your new shit, your single, or what you want to talk about.
It's the first single with Tony, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. Key sent us you and Tony, is it Limiter? Or is that?
No,
was just the mix.
And
then,
no, it's called Unique God.
With Tony, right?
Yeah.
There's two with Tony, though. There's one that says legit.
Nah, there's
no, legit doesn't have Tony on it. Just the one that says Unique God.
Okay.
Oh, that's my first single. I'm dropping. I did a whole album with 21's DJ. DJ Mark B. But he's a crazy ass producer. Like, if you know, if you heard like the little slash.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like the little knife sound.
Mm-hmm.
That's him.
Mm-hmm.
So we did an album. And like, it's just so well describing of Atlanta, and like it's perfect to me. So, but this first single is Unique God with Tony, and I was like, I felt like Lil Wayne on that song. Like I felt like a Carter II reminiscent feeling of the song. So I was like, you know, and Tony was right there with me. We felt it at the same time, and like the beat felt like that. So it came like that.
Nah, I hear it. I really do hear that. Now that you say that shit, bro, that's crazy. All right, so we're going to open up with that, I guess, and just
you want to give us the quick, like, radio intro? This is...
Man, it's Fat Man Key right now. I don't want to fuck the show up. What's the show name?
Nah, we not 9-7. Like, how
9-7 Oh, yeah, yeah. Look. I've been saying this all day before I got here. Let me start over. That was Fat Man Key. I'm at not 9-7.
Not 9-7,
but not 9-7. I'm at not 9-7, man. Stop playing with me, man. I'm about to premiere Unique Guy with Tony Snow right now.
Yeah.
Pieces fucking down. I'm from the A where all my bitches thick. We all players, baby, take your fucking pick. Damn, I want everything like the Onceler. I got young niggas smacking shit like the cucumbers. I just went to church and they was harmonizing. Plus I got it on me like I'm advertising. Damn, roll the weed, dog. Damn, this God, man, they got the weed, dog. Damn, I need a billion, I'm a beast, dog. Damn, roll the weed, dog.
I think you're going through hell right now. You need a
God. I told the bitch she would never understand me. I had you like a pilot, first class, I just landed. My check will cost a key. I African, my diamonds and my hoodie, Japanese. My bitch ratchet, I don't like the model hoes. I'm indecisive, I can't pick, so I need both of those. I look like I serve crack, diamond white, this triple black. You see in McDonald's, now when hungry, I just grab the Mac. Is it me or you, and I ain't going, so that's gonna be that. You try to be me, you should try to be realistic. All the guns got switches, we ain't tripping, we trip with it. Bitch is so bad that I had to put my dick in it. Every time I'm in a trap house, nigga, it's a lick in it. I told the jeweler I'm a plug, put a brick in it. Car automatic, but I got a stick in it. This bitch so bad, I had to let my bitch hit it. Caught a cool royal flush, cause I got that shit in it. Shit no. Shit no. Shit no. Shit.
Going through hell right now, and you need a God to walk the middle place. The God will not
mean?
Only be
no
here, but God.
That's crazy. This whole project, DJ Mark B.
Yeah, every single song.
So. You do this a lot where you're working with producers.
This is easy.
It's easier.
It's easier to do the work.
Yeah, and you are a producer, so does that easy to
like
translate?
It's easy and it's like, I don't know, it's more fun than going around and finding a whole bunch of different niggas and there's really not no story on the project.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's fire. What's my favorite bar, Matt? I ain't seen her shit like Helen Keller. Obviously, that's that Wayne shit like you saying where it's like witty punchlines. And it just, every line really a different punchline, which I don't think a lot of people even doing that type of shit anymore.
Yeah, you know, like everybody, I study Wayne.
Yeah,
for
course,
sure.
Of course.
That's a bar. Everybody study Wayne,
of
though.
Of course. But the metaphor is kind of lost,
though.
I wish
everybody
did. Nah, I feel like the metaphor like that not really being used,
some
though.
Motherfuckers, like. I heard a motherfucker say on the other song, fuck punchlines. I was like, nigga, what's the point of nigga music? Mean, you know, you kids mean as fuck.
Yeah, it depends. I feel like you're right though. Detroit, they like all punchlines sometimes.
I fuck with it though.
Yeah, that's fire. Yeah. That's
I appreciate it though.
Yeah, that's true. It depends on where you're from.
I appreciate what I'm listening to. Like I know what I'm listening to. I'm not listening to musical classical. Nah. I'm listening.
And
it gives you shit
to like hold on to. Like we were talking last night. We were listening to some song. One song had like a really big drop, and everybody's like ears perked up. We all looked at each other, and we're like, "Oh shit, this is getting crazy."
Right.
I feel like punchlines in a verse kind of do that, where like you're
listening
to the verse,
especially
and then
if you think it's something else that he's about to say.
Yeah,
my nigga Quaddy do that. Quaddy do that like you think a nigga about to say something, and they fuck you up.
Yeah, and then everybody looks at each other, they're like, "Yo, that was." What the fuck?
Yeah, bro. Yeah, that's shock. It's shock value.
Wordplay.
Yeah. It show how smart a person is, and that just keep it interesting.
Might
want
to listen to the same shit over and over. Guess we got life, dog. I mean, how many times you gonna say the same shit over and over again? You feel me?
Nah, facts. You need to make me niggas forget. Hip hop is sometimes funny.
Right.
You gotta have some
punchlines. It is funny.
It is supposed to be funny.
Man, this shit funny.
It's supposed to be funny.
Everything funny. Pain is funny.
Yeah, everything.
Seeing somebody else fall is funny.
Laughing my pain for real.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Nah, you're right.
You know, I love rap. I love. I don't even like country music and shit like that because, it's like
they take that shit too serious.
Now you strained your voice. You didn't really let me hear what you really wanted to say.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Get to the point. Fuck that bitch. Yeah. You
it's
know
like
what I'm saying?
It's like
what you yodeling for? Get to the point. You know what I'm saying? I'm drunk as fuck.
Yeah, nah.
I'm about to pass out. You know what I'm saying?
Shots fired at Yodel Kid.
Nah, Yodel Kid went crazy.
I enjoy it, but when it's time for that,
yeah.
I ain't there
rap,
yet.
In rap, so, it's storytelling or punchlines. I feel like if that's the truest form of rap, at the base, you got storytelling.
If you can stay balanced in the middle of all of that, you're the one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Basically.
If you can be a little bit of everything, you're the one.
Yeah. And how does it make you feel? Does it sound
right,
good?
Right. I don't give a fuck about nobody who could rap super good. Yeah. And if you ain't got no fucking soul and you ain't cool.
That shit sounds
like fucking Hobson.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not trusting the blue
you're
contacts.
You're not fucking with
the
contacts?
Nah. You already nasty.
That nigga used to be spitting his ass off. I'm like, yo, yeah. I am not interested.
Yo, shout out to Hobson. He caught a stray.
He really caught a stray. So that's the first single off the new project.
Shit sounded like some Dipset shit though, like some real like when you talk about Wayne, it sounded like Can't Feel My Face.
I appreciate the producer. I'm glad I didn't do it. I didn't bring out that side of me.
This is your first project in like 5 years.
Sheesh.
Nah.
You did what's the most
recent
project you put out? Not 777.
Oh,
y'all
looking at it?
Nah, not at the moment, but I can. I was looking at random shit.
I feel like I put some out. I put out an EP. Mm. Mama's Man.
Mama's Man. You put out Alpha Jerk in 2020.
Yeah, yeah. That's a beautiful ass album.
That shit is amazing. Still,
shout
still
out to Tony Seltzer, New York veteran.
Oh, facts. Tony Seltzer.
Yeah,
hell yeah.
That Cynical is a.
I ain't gonna hold you. That's up there with 777 of my favorites.
Yeah.
I think it was just the second album to me. Like, I feel like. That was the second one.
Yeah.
In my mind, I felt like that.
Nah, that one has a lot of replay value still to this day.
I was going to carry the method for 777 onto other producers.
Okay.
And I wasn't planning on staying with one person. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And so is this like the third version of that?
Nah, I haven't moved on from 777 because I haven't moved on yet. Let's not talk about that yet. That's an open.
No, but I mean, like, if that was the
open
first
case.
You and producer Kenny Beats, then you have you and Tony Seltzer, and now
yeah,
you have
like
in the
chain of music. Yeah. You're right. Yeah, like the Mark B album. Yes.
Yeah.
And hopefully you just gonna scale.
And
it
ain't gonna hold you because it's been going like that since Mothers.
Yeah.
It's like Mothers of the Blame, Fathers of the Curse. I kind of kept it like a J.K. Rowling type situation where I'm like, these are my books. You feel what I'm saying?
I love that.
Different series.
Yeah, for sure.
Nah, fire.
You did J.K. Rowling the rap game?
Yeah, for sure.
rap J.K. Rowling?
These are my books.
Yo, that's hard. That's the title of this episode.
Yeah,
rap J.K. Rowling.
Yeah.
Nah, facts.
Sure. Do you have, what other producers are on the vision board?
Dr. Genius. This is what I'm doing the album with right now, too.
Dr. Genius?
Hell yeah.
That's my all-time favorite.
Fucking Dr. Genius?
That's my number one, but.
That's crazy.
Yeah. I ain't gonna hold you. I love Pharrell. I love Chad. Chad is probably like my like all time favorite producer of all time. Like past Pharrell. But in my mind, on my personal scale of not being around anybody else or like anybody else's influence, because somebody else put me on Pharrell. You know what I'm saying? Like I didn't find him on my own. I felt like I found Cudi and them on my own.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I felt like I found that moment on my own where nobody had to push it onto me. You know what I'm saying?
Right generation, right time.
Cause I'm like before then it was nothing but for real. Like you know what I'm saying? Like Chad and the Neptunes and Star Trek. That's and even like Lil Jon, Timberland.
Especially out of Cleveland, which is crazy.
I love Lil Jon though. You know I'm from the A. He was a top producer and he did everything.
Yeah.
Damn, that's shout out to Lil Jon too.
Yeah, that nigga's a beast.
For sure. You wanna
all right, my song.
You wanna introduce your first song of the night and get Keys.
Yeah.
First impression?
Yeah. So, shit. I feel like I might have not fuck around heard this shit now that I already talked to y'all. But we're going to do fucking, you know, to do 4K Michael.
Nope.
Here we go. All right.
He from Baltimore.
Shout out to Baltimore.
Yeah. 4K Michael with Grease, with GRZ.
Niggas pussy. Niggas pussy, I heard the shit you say behind them pillows, it don't faze me. All my niggas living, all your niggas pushing daisies. Niggas click with me and get some money. Niggas click with you and then they die, ain't shit funny. Someone caught a thot on the tape and some money. You ain't with the bros, what can you get from me? Jesus, if I try to tell them, but they never did believe us. And I put my fire, I tell my brother, let's get even.
cheesy. Real shit hard, but the fake shit easy. I don't really think that you love me, believe me. I don't really think that you love me, you need me.
Stop lying on your motherfucking coochie. She went to far, she ain't never seen Gucci. Hoes gon' lie every time shit spooky. Niggas say love me, maybe acting like the groupies.
Trust me, I know that's your bitch, but I think she wanna fuck me. Damn, I feel bad for her nigga, he's a puppy. I get my way every time, bitch, I'm lucky. I can't do no drama with these niggas, that's so fucky. When I'm in PG with the hoes, I call up Lucky. Then my brother put up 2 points, easy bucket. Charlie said she wanna make a balance for your lucky. Think that I just lost a couple hundred, nigga, fuck it. We ain't really fucking, she ain't never trying to suck it.
Oh my God, bitch, stop lying on your motherfucking pussy.
Really love my city, but it don't get easy. My two best friends, real life breezy. I done seen it all, man, I feel like cheesy. Real shit hard, but the fake shit easy. I don't really think that you love me, believe me. I don't really think that you love me, you need me.
Yeah, we about to be on.
Yeah. So my boy, yeah, he pretty young, bro.
I fuck with it.
Yeah,
it was chaotic.
It's chaotic. You know what I'm saying?
It's raw.
Exactly. It sounds like Baltimore to me. You feel me? In a way,
it sounds chanty. I like what all the, like, I would say it's young, but all the, like, the third layering voice vocals.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like Jada Young used to do that. I listen to him shit. Rest in peace. Because I'm like, I don't know if you engineer, but it's called, what's that shit called? A 004?
Yeah.
So I appreciate that. I feel like the young kids is using it. And I like that shit a lot. It sounds like it's a lot of people when there's only one person talking.
Yeah.
Yeah, he uses that often, kind of. Like, that's kind of his thing.
I fuck with it, though.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
Jada Youngin uses it a lot, too.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I like this music.
But it definitely gave me that raw energy. Like, you know what I mean? Even when you had.
It was chaotic. Yeah, I like
your
it.
Song.
Yeah.
You got your chaotic moments, too.
Room to grow, room to do whatever you want to do. This is like, that seemed like a song where he was trying to showcase a lot of what he can do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
And like we were saying before, there's definitely lines that get stuck with you in that chorus. Also, when his vocal switches up and the flow switches up, and it's kind of like
a whole different song.
Yeah. And it's kind of like.
It's good for a video.
Yeah.
It's great for a video.
Hearing it maybe in the headphones, it may not translate the same, like you're saying, but in the video, it looks, but
you'll have to strap me in the chair, to listen to somebody's raw music like that.
Yeah.
Like, well, now if he made a song, like I said, we just talking about, like, it's more calculated. He's gonna learn, man. Let a nigga be young.
Yeah, I'm saying that, because it's like, to me, that's like the future, like la di da di da. Like when he just goes into that weird high pitch shit, and you're just like,
yeah.
It almost gets harder.
I like it.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. A lot
somebody
of that,
loves it. Shout out to Baltimore. Shout out to PG County. Shout out PG, all of that.
I love that. I like it. Somebody loves it.
Yeah, for sure.
Nah, but the energy is there. That's
so real, though. That's like the nicest way to say that.
Somebody in love with it. That's what matters, sure, bro. It's for Baltimore.
A fat girl.
Nah.
She cool.
I haven't heard
somebody love her, though.
Who the fuck?
Quadi say he love all the fat girls, man.
That's wild.
Yeah.
That's wild. All right.
Are you playing yours?
I think we got a little time. I think because we were just talking about the Neptunes.
Oh, you gonna go
and Chad little. And all that shit. I had a kid from Florida named Jay Safari, who's very much child of the Neptunes. If anything, still trying to figure out what his own sound is, but definitely, like, I like where it's going. So this is Made Up by Jay Safari.
Mine was made up. No, don't play, don't go. The feeling's almost done. Mine was made up.
see our life. Don't feel the same for only one night. And if we made up, things would never be the same.
So, Jay Safari, Florida, young kid, only has three songs out. The first one was a song called Dance, which was like even more, very like in the Neptune's pocket. But when you asked me who produced it, I looked it up. This dude, Trevino. Produced all three of his tracks. And I bet you that this is a SoundCloud link up because this man is based in Belgium. And I bet you, it's one of them shits where like he found this shit on SoundCloud and they just hit that pocket and just went for it.
For sure. Yeah, the beat is a fucking amazing. Yeah. But I ain't gonna hold you. I was about to sleep on but the hook was crazy and I'm like, yo, you know what I'm saying? That fucking
some
real.
Shit. Yeah.
He was saying some shit. I was about to sleep for a second. And I'm glad I didn't know. Yeah. But if you said that's his third song, he's straight.
Yeah.
Let these young niggas be young. They gonna get it.
Yeah, even with that, even though, you know, Matt was a little hesitant because it was so Neptunes.
Yeah, I liked
but,
it. I loved it.
Yeah.
Reminded me of some Bad Boys 2 shit.
And bro, he sound like Black Justin Timberlake.
House beat.
It's
a Big Mama.
Big Mama House beat is crazy. Big Willie style beat. Nah.
All about the Benjamins chasing you.
Yeah, get him a sync. Get him a licensing deal. Get him something in the movie, babe.
That's so crazy.
Get him in the Bad Boys 4. You know what I mean?
Shout out to Jay Safari. Young kid really figuring it out.
Out of Florida, man. I can't wait. When y'all should, I know I don't really go back and listen, do shit like this right now. So it's
most
like,
artists say that shit. That's
refreshing.
Why I would do this shit, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But it's dope to see because watch. In the year, this nigga going to be insane. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Yeah, bro. I mean, that's what we hope is we could find some early shit. And that's when you was here early, you'd be like, damn, I remember they played that shit. And now they big as fuck.
That's
like,
hard. That's hard. I'm pretty sure everybody appreciates y'all. That's good why job. Y'all in this building.
Yeah, man. Well,
so
I think,
if you have anybody.
Yeah. Top of
mind. You want to play a song of, we can cue it up.
All right.
What's up?
Okay.
I know it's on the spot, so.
Let me see.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll type it.
Yeah, go ahead. My bad, I got Stephen A. up on there. Motherfucker be yelling at me in the morning.
I'm plugged in, though, so let me know what it is. I'll play it. Because I got the aux.
I'm going to just play his latest song because I like everything from my boy, though. You feel me? It ain't fair that he's from where I'm from, but sorry. He hard, though, you know? But Bell One Boss.
Okay,
you can pick any song, bro, like that.
Okay.
Let me see.
hold on, my bad.
Huh?
Bear One Boss, but Bear let's see. Boss. Let's see the one day. Which one? Fair.
Bear One Boss. Fair. One More Chance he dropped yesterday.
But is that too new?
Nah, go ahead.
Yeah.
He would love that.
Let's check it out.
I want to see the video. I haven't seen it either. It's that new.
You can get that, you don't owe me. You can get that, you don't owe me. Hop on the back of I got that cash and booty. I'm in that bitch with my 2-1-0, yeah, I'm my candle, yeah, I'm in that bitch like in Cody. I'm in that bitch like in Eminem, yeah, we got Eminem, got my number on some road. I'm a stunner, fucking issue. I go freaky, going in on my feet. Yeah, I can't go to the Lord. Oh, Jesus, calling Jesus, and just want my mental.
That short and sweet shit.
Yeah, nah, he ain't playing though. If you really break it down, that nigga be talking shit.
What he said, I hot like the sunlight, Naivizu. Yeah. He said he got that shit because, you know, Naivizu got that little Japanese sun on they shit. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like
he be jumping in some shit. My boy be in a different bag. I ain't gonna hold you.
I honestly, like, that's what, like, got me there too, because that beat has all the little playful, like,
oh yeah, shout out to Pop Star Benny. You know, he's known for that. He
not
flushed
Trap Star
shit.
Benny no more. Or
Pop
that,
Star.
That's two different.
That's two different people.
Yeah. Okay.
Trap Money Benny.
Trap Money Benny.
Yeah, that's who did Drake shit.
Yeah.
But that's also like one of my favorite, my first collaborators.
I was gonna say I forgot even to bring that up.
He's from Ohio though.
Yeah. Okay. And but that was a SoundCloud link up, or that was on some Atlanta
shit? We linked through Tezo. If y'all live Cleveland, Tezo, Machine Gun Kelly.
Yeah.
We linked through that camp. But he up there too. He gone. He doing like fucking speakers and shit.
But yeah, it's
custom
it's,
audio.
But Popstar Benny is a new producer from the A.
Okay.
And he's crazy. He's into all of that. And he got a gang of artists. Like he is a record label. And so it kind of remind my swag like of me. Like when I, you feel me.
And this is one of his artists.
Nah.
Oh no.
Oh, he with the gang. Nah.
But this, we didn't even intro the song. That was Bear One Boss. One More Chance.
Yeah, Bear One Boss.
How long you been on listening to
him? I don't want to say I'm better for half his life, but I don't know.
But he's young. He very young.
He like 25.
Yeah.
Okay. He growing up. You can watch him grow up in this bitch, but he gonna be huge. I ain't gonna hold you. He always like to say who he like, but I'm pretty sure that them niggas like him now at this point. You feel what I'm saying?
I feel like also there's a space where the post is now gonna be a post thug. Era now.
That's what I was saying. I was about to say that. Like,
it is what it is, but it is.
Nah, it ain't gonna be no post thug. And even if something happened to thug, if the thug go to jail, I'm pretty sure he got hella gang of music. Yeah. Like he dead.
Nah, he ain't dead. You right. He still got a lot of sauce.
It's not a
lot of sauce.
Thug because thug will continue to like evolve.
Right.
But
it's so much
like,
music you've never
like,
heard.
It's like a post. It's post what thug created. The children of thug.
Yeah. I ain't gonna hold you. Shout is a lot.
Yeah.
He's a lot. Like, cause he loves Uzi.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying, but he's a lot because he and then like I had to find myself in there too.
Yeah,
he's a lot. No, sometimes it sounds totally different, but I love Bear because he listens too, and sometimes he don't listen too. Like,
yeah,
you feel what I'm saying? Like sometimes he'll run on a song forever. I'm like, where's the hook at? I'm like, I don't need no hook.
I think, contrast between a beat like that and then him actually having pockets where he's saying real shit about where he's from and like him coming up. Is like, I don't know. It just like creates a very.
How much time y'all got more? I got three more. I got two more.
We don't have too much time, but yeah,
we got one more. We got one more.
Throw one more.
All right, I'm gonna do this for my man. It's my bro right here. I'm in the studio with Quadi Diesel too. That's my bar for bar. This nigga go crazy. Don't sleep now.
So
know
that's
that.
That's another one
from Delaware. Shout out to Quadi. He right next to me. It's hard to talk about your man's when he right with you. You feel me? But that nigga's a beast. And then my brother Sig right here is Sig different. That's the one who told me we was talking about the dipped in butter shit.
Yeah.
Get my niggas some swag on that. Shout out to Telly.
it in the headphones.
All right. And you know what? Because we're on time, we will, let's have this song just play it out.
Yeah.
So we'll do our little outro. But all that basically means is,
we're going to thank you for being here.
Thank you for being here.
Man, thank y'all. I appreciate it. I had fun,
yo,
man.
My guy. Really
appreciate I had fun, you. Man. Shout out to y'all. 997, man. I got this shit now.
Yeah. By the end of the episode, you got it. That's all that matters. Yeah.
We got stickers for you.
And
for sure.
We're going to keep tapping in with you, bro.
For sure. I appreciate y'all, man.
Can't
wait
for the
project.
This is
a good experience, man.
Thank you, bro.
Music need this.
Yo.
Thank you, bro. Yeah, we're going to clip that up.
Thank you for stopping by. We're excited to see the record come out.
Man, look, I got a self-titled album coming out August, Marquis. And I have multiple singles coming throughout the summer. I can't wait, but, you know.
Yeah.
Let's go. All right,
you
want to
now do the radio intro of your boy's song.
Okay, cool. This Yo Sig is on me. Yo Sig!
On 997.
Well, 997, bitch.
Yo, sick. Eyes top notch, up low. I ain't outside. I rock clocks. I don't rock Gucci flip flop. Baby, queen down. Safety off. Don't get shot. I'm the type to shoot it up and hide when it get hot. Pull these eyes on me. Use a potato, now I got fries on me. She like, Sticky, why you winning? Raise your price on me. Cause I'm loaded up, got these eyes on, got all of these eyes on me. She threw me off my pivot, ice my knees so I can sprint again. I pray to God to bless me with some reach so I can sin again. Would you look at that, it's time to win again.
I don't want no pussy, I want money, what's your SSN?
I don't want no handy, that's for you. Anything I buy, I'm buying too. Anything we get, I'm gonna divide by two. Then I'm gone, that's fine by you. Got these eyes on me. When I sleep, I still bang. I don't give a fuck if you strip. What's your real name? You gon' hold this Glock 19 in your pot of hers. Now you gotta work. If they come, you better shoot.
Eyes top notch, upload. I ain't outside. I rock clocks. I don't rock Gucci flip flop. Baby, queen down. Safety off. Don't get shot. I'm the type to shoot it up and hide when it get hot.
Use a potato, now I got fries on me. She like, Sticky, why you winning? Raise your price on me. Cause I'm loaded up, got these eyes on, got all of these eyes.